Good morning, everybody. Welcome to your last Blessed Thankful Thursday, July 28, 2022. This is episode 794, part 1. And this one we're going to be learning about our understanding of creation. Beginning with Nehemiah 9, verse 6, compiled from John D. Morse. So if you're excited about another Blessed Thankful Thursday, smash the like button. What is your understanding on the subject of creation? Let me know in the comments. But subscribe if you're new, turn on notifications, share the video and channel with your family and friends. Help me reach a reasonable subscriber amount at least 15 or 20. By episode 800, which is now 6 days away. So, let's see what our understanding of creation is. Nehemiah 9 verse 6 says, "Thou, even thou, art Lord alone. Thou hast made heaven, the heaven of heavens, with all their hosts, the earth and all things that are therein, the seas and all that is therein, and thou preservest them all, and the host of heaven worship thee." So the Bible clearly states that God created the heaven and earth, the sea and all that is it, that in them is, Exodus 20:11, out of nothing. Things which are seen were not made of things which do appear. Hebrews 11:3. So the first verse of the Bible, "In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth," could be paraphrased, "God called into existence the space, mass, and time," otherwise heavens, earth, beginning, universe. Evidently, before creation, nothing now intrinsic to the universe existed at all. So while this teaching is clear, not hard to understand, it is hard to believe. Such ex nihilo, out of nothing, E-X-N-I-H-I-L-O, nihilo, ex nihilo, out of nothing. Creation is so foreign to our experience that it can only be comprehended as God reveals it to us. And we are taught that His creative work was finished at the end of the sixth day of the creation week. Genesis 2, 1-4. So with the exception of certain of the miracles of Christ on earth, such creation has not occurred since. And we have difficulty believing it could happen. So foreign it is to our experience. So we have difficulty believing it could, that the before everything was, there was nothing. We have a hard time believing it. But we also have a hard time believing in Judgment Day, the end time. We know about it, but we won't believe it till we see it. Till we actually see what we've learned come to fruition. You get what I'm saying? So our difficulty stems primarily from the fact that we are sinful creatures. Our minds are hampered by sin. In 1 Corinthians 2:14 it says, "The natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him. Neither can he know them, because they are spiritually discerned." And speaking of being nothing before, who created God? God was always there. God always was. So how did he get? I guess he was just formed back whenever, and he went for a while, and then he finally wanted to create the universe. So he created the universe, and then he wanted to create people or beings in his own image. Or so that's when he created man, Adam, and then he created a woman to be able to procreate, to have something to multiply with. So he created woman. So there was the first man and woman. And then he created the animals and everything. And Adam got to name these animals. So before long, the world was booming after the flood. And then it is what it is today. So trying to believe what light, what it was when God created Earth. It was just nothing before Earth was created, or the universe was created. It was nothing. Pitch black nothing. It's how in the world did he come up with all this? How did he come up with the idea of the universe, humans, animals? We may never know until the end time, when he brings us home to straighten out the world the way it should be. So since the doctrine of creation is foundational to the rest of Scripture, we dare not neglect it just because it is difficult. And we dare not impose our feeble naturalistic reasonings unto the clear teaching of Genesis chapter 1 and related passages, thereby reducing God's power to mere human abilities. So the ultimate debate about this one can go on and on and on. I'm not going to linger on it too much. So. But You leave me your thoughts in the comments below about that. Just a brief comment about your debate on creation. What's your outlook on the creation? So coming up tomorrow in your episode 795, part 1, we're going to be back in the Does series again for another couple days in it, and we're going to be in number 99 of the Does series with the ministry of the saints, beginning with 1 Corinthians 1 verse 2, and all compiled from Henry M. Morris. And Saturday we'll be doing the same thing, the series, with number 100 of the series, with the Word of His Grace from Henry M. Morris. So, like I said, this book is going to have about 106 the series. We're gonna go up to 106. We're gonna end that, or that'll be the last. We'll have 106, and that'll be the last one in this book. We'll have to wait till the next quarter to go to 107 and beyond. So, but it's just an ongoing series. So, but stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes. I'll get that sometime later tonight, but you'll see that tomorrow. I'll be doing the Friday and Saturdays in the next session, in the next recording session. So, coming up at 1 o'clock today, we're going to be talking about part 2 of episode 794, and when the whole world sings, from Mart Dehaan, MartDehaan, Mart Dehaan, derived from Revelation 5:8-14. So stay tuned for that. I'll get to that in just a few minutes, but you'll see that after 1 today. So with that said, I love you. I appreciate you. Thanks for watching. Keep on keeping on and trusting God. And He'll keep you safe in all you say and do in 2022 and beyond. And until later, peace out, everybody. So long, farewell. Come back later after 1 for when the whole world sings. Should be a good one. So, until then, God bless everyone, and I'll see you later. Goodbye.